Who would have ever thought you'd have to manage the life cycle of a cloud? Coming up next on HP Tech Talks. Hi, I'm Andy McCaskey from SDR News, and this program is called HP Tech Talks, where we talk about how Hewlett-Packard is defining a new style of IT. And we talk with HP experts from networking and servers and storage. And today we're going to be talking with the folks at HP Cloud. And our guide for cloud services, as always, Mr. Stephen Spector. Stephen, how are you doing?
Well, I'm doing great, and happy new year to yourself, Andy, and everyone else out there watching. And it's exciting to start again and continue our cloud journey. I know everyone uses that word as well as HP. And I have with us another expert for us who knows more about cloud than just about anyone else I know. And she's quite sharp, and she is the Senior Product Marketing Manager for our cloud service automation solution. So let me introduce you to Neelam Chakravarty. I have to look to make sure I say that right. Neelam, did I get that right?
You got it perfectly right.
Oh, great. Well, Neelam, I'll let you go ahead and introduce yourself, and then we'll get started.
All right. Hello, everyone. Happy New Year to you. This is Neelam Chakravarty. I am a product marketing manager with Cloud Service Automation. And I've been with HP for 3 years now, mostly working in the cloud area. I've had experience in both enterprise as well as small business.
Cloud is happening so quickly, and there's so much going on. It must be an exciting place to work at HP.
It is. It is definitely very exciting. And specifically, the product that I'm working on, which is HP Cloud Service Automation, is kind of one of the core elements of the larger or the broader HP Converged Cloud Strategy. And definitely the times here are very exciting. I'm very excited to be part of this team.
Well, maybe if you can kind of set the stage and show how cloud service automation fits into HP's greater vision of cloud computing.
All right. So let me first tell you what the product is. Cloud service automation is basically lifecycle management for cloud services. And what I mean by lifecycle, like anything else in the world, cloud services have lifecycle too, which means that you need to design and create a service, then you publish it into the catalog so that your users can view them and order them. And then you finally have to manage the services. And once you're done with everything, your users don't longer require the services, or if they are out of compliance, you retire them. So that's a complete life cycle of a cloud service. And cloud service automation helps customers manage this complete life cycle in both private cloud as well as hybrid cloud environments. Now, as you may know, and as the customers may know, that HP cloud, a converged cloud strategy is really supporting that true hybrid cloud strategy, which not only includes private and public cloud, but managed cloud, which is managed by a third party, as well as traditional IT. And it has this, it supports this three C's, we call them choice, confidence, and consistency. And HP Cloud Service Automation definitely offers all these three ingredients to build a successful cloud. So our latest release of Cloud Service Automation is CSA 4.0, and we announced it at HP Discover in this past December. So there's some really new exciting additions to this release. One of the very new ones that's something that users can see and they're really excited about is the new UI. We had a pretty good UI, but we have kind of rehauled it to make it more modern and fresh. You know, if you look at the latest applications and tools out there, they have really good looking UI. And it's not just the looks, but the design, you know, easy navigation, because the consumers are not necessarily highly technical. So anybody who uses the UI has to be able to navigate it much more quickly. So with that in mind, we have kind of rehauled the UI both on the consumer side, consumers who order the services, as well as on the IT admin side. So the product is much more user-friendly and very intuitive in nature.
Neelam, why should customers care about native integration of cloud OS in the cloud service automation world?
All right. So HP Cloud OS, as you may know, is a technology that has been built using open source OpenStack. And OpenStack is creating a lot of buzz in the industry today because of its openness and helping customers avoid vendor lock-in. A lot of customers are experimenting, but OpenStack is, again, a technology that is going to be a reality soon. So HP has been a leader in this open source technology. It seriously believes that clouds are meant to be open. So it has developed this new technology cloud called HP Cloud OS, which is kind of an operating system for cloud. And its native integration with cloud service automation means now customers have more choice. So you no more have to choose between vendor A or B. You have a choice which is open. You can use number of tools and technologies that can work with OpenStack. And so HP Cloud OS and Cloud Service Automation together work together to give you a solution that helps you provision into an external environment, as well as a management capabilities, which includes compliance, security, monitoring that is offered by CSA. And the tightness of the integration means a robust and a more scalable offering.
All right. So as an example, just to make sure I've got the concept here, if you have a template that is developed to support cloud operations in one environment, let's say in a private environment, you could transfer that to some other vendor's public cloud for certain operations. There's an interoperability issue here. Do I have the idea?
Yes, that's exactly correct. So let's say that, for example, if you built your private cloud using an offering that supports OpenStack. Now, if you were to, let's say tomorrow, decide that you want to port your workload to a public cloud, for that to happen, first of all, it's not possible today. But for that to happen, you have to have an underlying architecture that both of them support OpenStack. So if you have a public cloud that's built on top of OpenStack, and you have a private cloud that builds on OpenStack, it makes the workloads portable. And that's what we are trying to do here.
So I see the acronym TOSCA, T-O-S-C-A. What is that?
Well, if you Google TOSCA, the first link that comes up talks about an opera. That's not what it is. TOSCA is an acronym that stands for Topology Orchestration Specification for Cloud Applications. And what that is it is a new emerging standard, cloud standard, just like any other standard that we have in IT. And the goal of TOSCA, basically, which is actually driven by a nonprofit consortium called OSS, and it is supported by large names like IBM, SAP, HP, et cetera. And the goal of TOSCA is basically to build or lead into building interoperable and portable clouds. So today, now that cloud has become more of a reality, it's no more a hype, the next step in advancement of cloud is basically trying to find interoperable clouds. So with so many solutions available out there, it becomes very, customers kind of get driven into single vendor solution, and they get locked down into the solution for a long time. But customers are looking for best of breed technologies and tools, which are not necessarily built by the same vendor. So if I were to use a mix of all these different technologies, I want them to work together. I want them to work in vendor A's environment. I want them to work in vendor B's environment because my business needs change. And at a later point of time, if I've changed my mind to go to another technology, another vendor, or another environment, I should be able to do so. And TOSCA standard helps me to make my cloud portable and interoperable.
As you work with customers, there surely must be some one or two critical items that you have to work with them to help them understand that's really essential to utilization of the product. What would that be?
One is that you have to understand your customer requirements, as any other business, right? But why it becomes critical in cloud applications is that not all applications are built to be ported into the cloud. So you understand your applications, you understand your needs. And as you Stephen mentioned, cloud is a journey. That's what is our philosophy. It's not a one-time event. So if you are thinking of migrating to cloud, you have to kind of put a plan together that starts with, prerequisite is automating all your tasks and processes, then slowly taking the non-critical applications into the cloud, testing them out, and then taking more critical applications as you become more mature and your environment becomes stable. And cloud service automation helps you to grow. You know, you don't have to make an upfront investment into big monolithic solution because it has that open and flexible architecture. So today your business needs a small, or you're experimenting with cloud, you start small. But tomorrow you want to bring in some other critical components of cloud, for example, security, compliance, monitoring. You can add that at a later point of stage. And so cloud service automation's open architecture helps you to grow at the same time be flexible.
Do you find certain business units or certain departments are maybe unrealistic in their expectations, or maybe they're trying to move too quickly? And if so, who would they tend to be?
Yes, there are, because, you know, there has been so much hype about cloud and the benefits of it in terms of cost savings and bringing about business agility, time to market. So IT organizations under pressure to, you know, show those results quickly. But cloud is not something that you implement to immediately start seeing the results, because, as I mentioned, it does need planning, upfront planning. And then once you have put into, you have put the services into the cloud, it does take time for it to mature. There is a learning curve because there has been a back-end change in the processes and tasks. And by the time everything stabilizes and you really start reaping the benefits, there is some time lag between that. And customers, initially when we started maybe a few years back, that was the expectation. But as customers themselves are maturing and they're understanding cloud more and more, they are level setting their expectations. And so now they understand is that if they implement cloud today, they're not going to see the benefits tomorrow. Some of the low-hanging fruit they do see, but then really the bigger benefits come at a later point of stage.
Right. If people wanted to get more information about cloud service automation and this product and the new user interface, where would be a good place for them to go?
They should come to me. No, just kidding. they would go to hp.com/go/CSA. That is one of the websites that talks about the product. But as I mentioned, CSA is just a product that fits into a bigger solution, which we call as cloud management. So the other website to visit then is hp.com/go/cloud-management.
Okay. Stephen, that's kind of a hard act to follow. But Neelam, thanks so much for joining us here today. And look forward to having a chance to see you maybe in person in some of the future HP Discover events.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Stephen. What's coming up next in the cloud journey in our description here?
Well, we'll keep moving on. And I think my description of Neelam knowing everything about cloud was pretty accurate. She really understands the fundamental aspects of it. And it's great to have her on our team, certainly. The next step is we're going to start to look at some of the companies that engage with us. A big part of cloud is not doing things yourself, but actually engaging partners. You know, HP has a lot of people, a lot of products, but there's certain pieces of cloud that will come from our partners. And I thought it'd be interesting to take a look at some of the alliances and learn a bit about who works with HP and what type of solutions we're looking for partners with.
Excellent. Well, again, thanks for joining us here. And also thanks to you folks for joining us today. We'll see you next time on HP Tech Talks.